Hey everyone, it's Victoria. Welcome back to my channel. Today I have a drugstore favorites video for you. So a lot of you have been requesting what are some of my favorite products from the drugstore. So I figured I'd just sit down and just go ahead and show you everything that I use. So this is gonna be a long video. So if you wanna get a snack, you wanna get some tea, you wanna get a Coke, go right ahead because you're gonna need it. First thing I'm gonna start with is my brow. The first thing I like that I've been using lately is this. It's the Milani 04 Brunette Pomade. I would say the only tip with this is to scoop some out on the back of your hand and go ahead and work it in because it does come out very waxy if you just apply straight from the pot. Next one is this NYX Micro Brow Pencil in the color Espresso. It's a really nice mechanical tip. So you can go ahead, it's similar to the Anastasia brow wiz. Yes, I really like it. The only problem with this is it's kind of waxy. So what I would do is I'll put this on and then what I will go ahead and take a setting powder and just set on top. Next, it's pretty new to my kit, but I really like it, is this Brow Stylist Definer by L'Oreal. And I use this in the color Dark Brunette. The next thing that I have is this NYX Eyebrow Powder. So I would say for my younger ladies or my ladies who have really nice thick brows, you can use this and you can get away with it because there's two shades here. A dark and a light brown. It does the job. And I never use the wax side of it because it does give you that wet look. So just use the powders. It does define, it gives you a nice strong brow. To set my eyebrows, I've been using this e.l.f. It's a eyebrow and eyelash combo. Price point, I think this is like $2, where other products are $5 and above. So I would say that that's such a great investment. The next thing is, now we're moving on to eyes. Use this NYX eyeshadow base. It's so similar to the Soft Ochre Paint Pot by MAC. I don't have a huge variety of shadows from the drugstore, but I do want to start investing more in the drugstore brands because I was pleasantly surprised this past month since I've been starting to start my channel. I've been trying to invest more in drugstore products. This Milani palette, the colors are stunning and they are very pigmented and they're easy to blend out. This one is in O2 Bare Necessities and I love it. It's honestly, it has some shimmers, it has two matte shades, and this is perfect for a transition color. This is perfect to deepen the crease, and you have these shimmery shades which are really nice. The thing that I have is this e.l.f. palette, and if you guys watched my last tutorial, you'll know that I freaking love this thing. It's so good. So this is called the Mad for Matte palette, and it's so good. It was $10. Look at how many shades you have. You have 10 shades in here. They're pigmented and they're easy to blend. So this is definitely something that you want to invest in. But these are beautiful. These are stunning. I used this in the last tutorial and these are the three shades that I could pick up. I'm going to go to the store to see if they have any more, and if they do, I'm definitely picking them up.
So these are the cream shadow size, and these are the glitters.
Glitters are not super intense. You have to build it up unless that's what you're looking for.
I'm sorry, one more.
I have this color from Milani. It's called Bella Sand, and this is their gel powder eyeshadows. And these last all day long.
These are so good. If you can get your hands on that, run, don't walk. Get those things, girl.
The next thing that I would move on to is my primers.
The Milani Prime Light. This is a strobing and pore minimizing primer. This is the Milani Prime Shield, and this is a mattifying and pore minimizing primer. And then I have the Baby Skin Instant Pore Razor.
It's something where you wanna definitely combine these two together. So I would start with this one, put it all over your face, then put the strobing cream wherever it is that you wanna highlight. You'll really like that combination. I love this pore minimizing Baby Skin. It's so good. Everybody loves Dr. Brand's Pores No More. I like it. I love this. So I think that tells you a lot about it. So next, I'm going to move on to my foundation. With natural, I'm gonna say we could do the Wet n Wild Photo Focus. I use this in the color Desert Beige.
This is so underrated. One, don't walk. Get this foundation. I love it. That's one thing.
This is the Maybelline Better Skin Foundation. This has SPF 15 in it. It doesn't give you flashback. I know that a lot of people tell you that, but for some reason, this doesn't give me flashback. I actually love the way I photograph when I'm wearing this. And this is in the color Rich Tan. The next one is the Milani Conceal and Perfect 2-in-1 Foundation Concealer, and this is in the color Sand. So pretty. It gives you a really natural finish. It does
more glowy
and matte looks. You know I'm gonna say it because you know I'm gonna say it. All right?
L'Oreal. Infallible line. Literally. So good. Okay? So good. So here we have the Pro Glow. Here we have the Pro Matte. L'Oreal. Hey. I need you to make a shade that fits me. Fits girls like me. I always gotta mix these two. That's why I have two of them. But
so what I'll do is sometimes is I'll put this dark color on the outside perimeter of my face and then this lighter one on the inside. And I just kind of blend it in and it looks nice. So same thing with this.
But yeah, L'Oreal, if you're watching, please. Color in between here for me. Thank you.
Now I'm going to move on to concealer. The two that I want to mention are the Maybelline Fit Me and the Maybelline Age Rewind. Those are really, really, really great drugstore concealers. I just don't have a sample of them because I run out of them. I do love this Maybelline Master Conceal. The only thing that I don't like about this is that I have to put it on the back of my hand and work the product in, so I feel like I'm wasting product. But it's only $5, I think, and it works really well. But underneath that, I like to use this Hard Candy Sheer Envy Instant Eye Fix. So what I like to do with this is it's a very salmon colored concealer, and what that does is it helps cancel out any dark circles underneath your eyes, and it provides like a base or a primer for your concealer to really brighten up those under eyes. So next, I love these two for my wings. Here is the Maybelline Eye Studio. This is a gel liner. It's super black, but it is like a dull, not that like super dark, straight matte color. Like this one is super dark matte. It's good to use a nice like angled brush with this, and you can really cut that wing. The next are pencil liners, and I like to use these in the waterline just to give yourself a pop of color.
So I have three colors here. I have a nude color, and this works really well to open up your eyes. I have a gold color, and it just gives you like a subtle openness, but it really just accentuates whatever color you have on your lids. And this is a tropical green, and these are from NYX, and these are from, and this is from Rimmel. And what I like to do in the color Milk, sorry. And what I like to do is use this to intensify my shadow colors. So I'll put this down as a base, and then it will really accentuate the color that I put on top.
So next, what I like to talk about is setting powders. And what I have here is a good powder to bake with, and that is the Coty Airspun Powder. It doesn't accentuate any dryness or dry patches for me. It really doesn't accentuate it, and it does a great job in baking and locking in your concealer so that it will stay all day. One of the dewier look is this Milani Prep Set and Glow. So what you can do is when you have a matte foundation and you want it to look more lively, you can throw on that Prep Set and Glow and just, you know, work your magic. The next thing I'd like to talk about is a contour and highlight palette. And this is honestly my favorite one, and it's from Wet n Wild. I have three shades. The one that I use is Caramel Toffee, and it works so well. It's such a nice warm shade to contour with, and so it's not too harsh, and you could bronze up your whole face. And then just to stay on the topic of bronzers, I love this Physicians Formula Bronzer Booster. The only issue that I have with Physicians Formula is this is the darkest shade.
So my chocolate ladies, you know, this is not gonna work. This is like a setting powder for my beautiful chocolate woman. So I need Physicians Formula to get on it because you have really great bronzer, but you don't have a great color scheme, and you can't be leaving people out.
The next thing that I want to talk about, and it's so important, I should have mentioned this like before everything, but I want to make sure that I mention it because I just had everything I thought in order and I just kind of like started going out of order. But it's so important for us to use sunscreen. This is a really great one from the drugstore in terms of beauty. Obviously any sunscreen is good for you, but this is SPF 50. It's lightweight and oil free, and this is from Equate Beauty. So I wanted to talk about our blushes. So this is Berry & More, It's a very nice dark, obviously berry color, but it has a nice subtle highlight in it. Okay, so I'm back. The next one, so we did Berry & More.
This one is Luminoso.
This one is Luminoso, and it's a very nice peachy coral type color, and it has like little gold reflex in it. So it's really pretty for, I think that it's really pretty for all year round.
This one is Delicioso Pink. Excuse my pronunciation.
It's really pretty. A light hand with this goes a long way. But this is nice for those days when you want to look really pinky and girly, and you know, it ties into your look. Next, we can talk about
highlights.
These are really nice. And Wet n Wild has like some tough ass packaging, I'll tell you that much, because they're like, oh yeah, you want to skimp on how much you're paying, then you better work for this.
But it always, this one and the contour and highlight palette, oh my god, it takes me forever. I'm like, just leave it open. So these are the four colors that you get in here. You get like a nice champagne, you get a nice gold, and then this is a nice blush topper, and this one is a nice pink. I think this pink one would look really pretty on you fair skin ladies. You have a nice subtle champagne color, and this is a nice gold color. So this would look beautiful on my chocolate skin ladies. And then like I said, this is a blush topper for all skin tones. And I have this Tantastic from Milani. I really like this. It looks so good, and when I saw it, it's called a big bronzer, but come on, this is like orange. This is like Snooki Jersey Shore orange. So this is not a bronzer, ladies. This is a really nice highlight for the summertime.
So now we're gonna move on to lips. Liners and then lipstick. I'll go with Milani first, and then I'll show you NYX, because those are the two brands that I have. Milani I have here, and that's 09 Spice. It's a really nice like brown mauve color. And then I have 02 True Red, and this goes really nice. It pairs really nice with obviously a dark red lipstick, or anything that has like a, that pulls in a berry color. The next three are from NYX, and I have here, I have mauve. So pretty, it's a true mauve. This is an excellent dupe for Kylie Cosmetics Chloe. I think that's what it is. Really pretty color. The next one that I have is Nude Truffle. This is really pretty, like a nice brown color. And then the next one I have is Ever. And this is a really pretty, like darker mauve color. Now we're moving on to lipsticks. This one is the Color Jolt by Maybelline in 05 Stripped Down. Next one that I have is from Natalia. Okay, it's a lipstick. It gives you a nice satin finish. It's not matte. This is NYX. It's a soft matte cream, and this is in the color Abu Dhabi.
Super pretty. They smell so good. They smell like cake batter. That's what it smells like. Viewers have dolls, and she sees her boyfriend, and that's why she can't get
it. This is the Butter Gloss in Fortune Cookie. I have her from Milani, and they are more matte lip crayons. I have the color Precious, 11 Precious, and then 13 Craze. And this is the one that I used in the last tutorial. Last but not least, I have...
Yeah!
Last but not least, I have these setting sprays. It's definitely important to set your makeup before you go out, especially if you want it to last long. And I have two here. This one you get at Target, and it's Pixi Makeup Fixing Mist. And then the next one is Milani Make It Last. They both smell phenomenal. So that is it for my drugstore favorites. I hope that some of these colors or some of these foundations or anything that I mentioned here will help you out when you're, you know, looking for makeup at the drugstore. I know how it feels to get some colors or some products that you just really don't like. So I hope you can come to this channel and see things that worked out for me. Hopefully they work out for you. And I'd like to start to have a conversation with you guys. So in the comment section down below, just leave me different, you know, tips that you might have, just suggestions, or just products that you love that maybe I haven't mentioned or maybe I haven't tried out. I love trying new makeup. And if you tried some of these products and you liked them and they were a hit or a miss to you, let me know. I will try to research more, maybe different type of skin tones, maybe different type of you know, skin types, and I'll try to find products that work for you guys. So I hope you enjoyed. Make sure to subscribe to my channel and leave some comments down below and some other suggestions. I am going to do a drugstore brush video soon, but my next tutorial should be on my Carly Bybel palette. So stay tuned for that. Thanks for watching, guys.